Hey, I'm Tim from timsphotos.com, and I'm going to show you how to quickly download and install your Adobe profiles into Lightroom and Photoshop. So your starting point for this is at timsphotos.com/profiles, which is where you can get your free sample set of the new Adobe profiles. And if you've already done that, then you would have ended up on a download page and you would have clicked that download files button. And this would have opened up a link within Dropbox. When you see the file within Dropbox, you want to click up in the top right corner, the download button, and then click on direct download. So for me, this just dropped this new folder that's all zipped up down into the bottom left of my browser bar there. And I want to click open when done. And what that did, because it's a zipped file, it opened up my unzipping program. So I'm going to click extract. And then I want to create a custom folder location for where I'm going to be saving this. I like to extract folders where I know exactly where they are. So in this case, I'm going to create a folder called Tim's Photos Profiles, and I'm going to click OK. And then I'm going to click the extract button, and it's going to push all of those folders, all of those files into that location. So after they've been unzipped, this is what it's going to look like. Now, this is a PDF file with instructions. Then there are 5 raw files for you to practice on. These are the same raw files that were in the sample pack video. If you only opted in for the free sample pack, you'll just have one folder here. It's called Tim's Photos Sample Pack. But if you bought the whole collection, you'll have about 15 or 16 separate folders here. So what you want to do is select all 15 or 16 folders. In this case, I'm only showing the one sample folder. And then I want to go Control C or Command C on a Mac, or right click and copy. And now that's been copied to the clipboard. So next, I want to open up Lightroom. And I'm going to go to, on a Windows machine, Edit and Preferences. And if this was a Mac machine, I would hit the Lightroom button over on the left and then Preferences. But I'm on a Windows machine, so it's Edit and Preferences. And it opens up this Preferences dialog box. This is the button here you want to look for. It's Show Lightroom Presets Folder. I'm going to click on it. And it opens up an Explore window where Lightroom is highlighted already. I want to scroll up to the Camera Raw folder, double click on it to open, and you'll see Settings. So I went up to the Camera Raw folder and then Settings. And then I just want to left click on Settings, but now right click and paste. And what that does, it pastes my profile folders into this Settings folder. Once that's done, you are done. All you need to do is restart Lightroom and restart Photoshop, and then check to make sure that your profiles have been applied. So the way that I check to see that they are applied is I make sure that I'm in the develop module of Lightroom, and you want to make sure you can see those 4 squares there and the word profile. If you don't see that and you're in the develop module, then you need to update your Lightroom. But I have updated my Lightroom, so I'm going to click on the 4 squares and it opens up all the profiles I have. So you're going to see down here the one that's called Tim's Photos Sample Pack, or if you purchase the whole collection, you're going to see all of these: cityscapes, dark foreground, dark forest, green moss, sunsets, sand dunes, etc. And now let's just jump over to Photoshop really quick. It's the same deal with Photoshop, except you're not going to see them unless you're in the RAW editor. So this happens to be a JPEG, and I'm going to force the RAW editor open by going Filter and Camera Raw Filter. That forces the raw editor open, and there are the four little squares again to browse profiles. You just have to make sure that this basic tab has been selected and not one of the other tabs. So the basic tab, and then you see the profile, four little squares. So if I click them, it forces me to browse profiles. And down lower here, here's all of the Tim's Photos profiles that are purchasable. And if you only installed the sample pack, then you'll only have the sample pack. So if I open up on one of these, you can see the various profiles. There's five in the sample pack. And I would just scroll through and find the one that I want to use. Now, of course, this photo here has already been completely adjusted. So there are no profiles that are going to look good on it because it's already color corrected and it's got the right amount of saturation that I like. So I would just click the one that I want and then click on the percentage that I want it. See, now I'm at 26%, 100%, 150%. So I would choose the percentage that I actually want to see, then click close. And now all my sliders are at zero and I have a fresh start. So there you go. That is how you install the Adobe profiles into Photoshop and Lightroom.